You said rock and roll was only for people who were cute at one point. Do you think rock and roll is still for people who are simply cute?
It's more for people who are cute now than it ever was before, because it's virtually impossible to get a record contract if you look, you know, anywhere between normal and ugly. You may play great and sing great, but if you're not cute, you can't get a contract now, because it's the world of videos. It's easier to get a contract now if you can't sing and you can't play, but you look good, because they can always hire somebody to sing your song for you. You've seen that happening over and over and over again. Every hit that you hear on the record, on the radio, who's really singing it? Who's doing it? Because the person that you see in the video is dancing and looking good with nice clothes and everything, and it's all fake. No question about it, hell in a handbasket. No question about it, hell in a handbasket.
Sike, you've given up hope.
The Sykes-Picot arrangement, whatever it was.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, it's really depressing. If you stop and think about trying to get people to pay attention to what the government is doing or actually taking some personal involvement in it, it's hopeless, because even if you got them to register, they don't know enough about what's going on to make a decision after they've registered. So maybe it's for the best if they don't register.
So how do they become more informed? I mean, they become a news addict like you? And well, that news is so skewed anyway.
Well, I'm watching the same skewed news that's available to everybody else. I don't have any kind of secret information that comes filtering into my house. But what I've learned to do over the years is subtract the spin. And so if you flip from channel to channel and see the different ways a story is covered, you can average it out and get some idea of what's going on. And then the fact that certain stories are reported at all is very suspicious. And you learn to spot these, you know, why are they talking about this now?
another project of yours is called Thing Fish, mm-hmm. which is about, as I understand it, sexually transmitted disease, particularly amongst homosexuals. I mean, I would say it was AIDS, if you like. Which...
Well, in this thing, it's called the mystery disease, but it's quite obvious that it is an AIDS-like disease, and it's been manufactured on purpose, and it's being transmitted on purpose, and the purpose is to rid the planet of certain people. I believe that AIDS, in reality, is not a natural accident. It's not a natural disease that just sort of evolved. Somebody cooked it up. I think that it's something that either escaped from a genetic engineering laboratory or something that was manufactured on purpose in a genetic engineering laboratory to somebody's specifications. I also believe that all the warfare of the future will be conducted with these biological agents, because now that gene splicing is a thing that can be done, it is feasible to consider the preparation of certain diseases which will kill only specific races, nationalities, or people with certain interests. Because you can tailor the disease to attack certain things in certain categories.
But these are very serious allegations, Frank. I mean, what actually makes you believe this? Do you have hard and fast evidence that this is the case, or is it just something that you've theorized?
No, this is just the opinion of an aging buffoon. You know, just think nothing of it.
you think that possibly America or any other country in the world could increase its power and its standing internationally by actually utilizing these agents?
Let's look at the world the way it really is. Government is a joke. Governments don't do anything. That's like a cardboard cutout that hides where the real machinery is. The world is a place that does business. The world is run by multinational businesses that mostly sell weapons to each other. Then you have sugar business, oil business, coal business, you know, business. And when the guys who run these things say jump, all governments jump. And it's foolish to consider the possibility of nuclear war, because from a business standpoint, it's impractical. It stops all business. So the way you have to look at it is, the chances are much more likely that the sales will continue of missile delivery systems, but what will be in the warheads will not be things that destroy real estate. It's much more practical to think of missiles going someplace and putting out chemicals or microbes that enable the one party to subjugate the other party by controlling its labor force while leaving the buildings intact. So you've subjugated them, and now you got a bonus, you have their machinery, you got this, you got that. And I believe that there's somebody sitting in an office someplace that's working on it, then that's the practical way to do it. You can scream about nuclear war and you have people running around with signs and stuff like that, but I don't believe there will ever be a nuclear war, because it's just impractical from a business sense. Meanwhile, the companies that are building delivery systems are making plenty of money, billions of dollars, because the money goes into small arms delivery systems, medium-sized arms. Their commerce is still going on, and that's why they're alive. That's what they love to do. Thank you.
moment. I said, don't throw anything on the stage. The next thing that comes on the stage, good night, folks. Get the picture?
For some of you to know that there is a some sort of strange national effort to bring censorship to first the rock and roll industry, then to the video industry, then the National Council of Churches wants to have ratings on normal television programming, and then it'll get to books, and then it'll get to any kind of sign you want to carry around the street, and then you'll all be wearing the same color clothes, and I don't think you're all going to learn how to speak Chinese, but I think that they all want you to sort of worship the same God. most people in the United States are smart enough to realize that if a parent does not want their children to hear objectionable material, they have many alternatives. One, don't buy a record at all. Two, shop in the children's section. Get your 8 or 9 year old child a Smurf record or something like that. Three, buy instrumental music. Have you ever thought of letting your children hear jazz or classical music?
Voluntarily labeling in no way infringes upon First Amendment rights. Labeling is little more than truth in packaging, by now a time-honored principle in our free enterprise system. And without labeling, parental guidance is virtually impossible.
What I suspect is that because rock and roll music reaches so many different people, and it does reach them on a repetitive level, and it does form an important part of their life, if you can control that medium, you are going to be able to control the ideas which go out to those young people. And there are some people who don't want to have young people thinking too much, because you got to keep them really stupid to buy certain products and to vote for certain people.
people who need to be entertained, okay, it's doing its job. But I have a different view of music. I think that it has an aesthetic importance that goes beyond chart placement. And the business of music is all about this fake list of who sold what. And the whole idea of selling large numbers of items in order to determine whether or not the item has any quality to it is what's really repulsive about it. And the function that is required of you as a musician in the United States basically is please be a jukebox. It's not even please, just be a jukebox. We want you to play whatever it is you just put out on your record, and we want it to sound just like the record. And so this desire on the part of the audience to have live in-person replication of freeze-dried material is one of the forces that led to the Milli Vanilliism that we now see, because a lot of the contemporary albums, you can't play it live. You have to just have a track playing in the background and, you know, fake it all.
Musicians will always make music. However, the people who make records are not always musicians. You know, sometimes they're just plain show people. Or, in the case of some of the punk groups, they're guys off the street that were gathered together by a boutique owner. You know? The fact of the matter is that advertised properly, people will buy anything. See? And now that the lesson of punk has been learned, that you can sell anything to anybody, there's no telling what the next trend will be.
music of today. What direction is it going in?
It's going to the bank.
Is that a creative assessment? Is that good for music?
It's not good for music, but the accountants love it.
Mm-hmm. How about radio?
Same thing.
Are you at all embittered by the fact that the same people get played on commercial radio?
I don't listen to the radio.
So you have nothing to be...
You guys shouldn't either. There's nothing in it for you.
What about television? Watch much television?
No. I like the news. I watch CNN most of the time.
Mm-hmm. Did the news ever get you down? I mean, that's not a...
No, I like to watch the news because I don't like people very much. And when you watch the news, you know, if you ever had an idea that people were really terrible, you can watch the news and know that you're right.
We'll be right back.
Let's ask ourselves, what was he doing during the war? Politics is the entertainment branch of industry.
Well, I was hiding over at Bitburg and...
They do more to entertain us than to serve us.
Well.
It seems that the problem with government as an institution is uniformly bad worldwide. It may be the only thing that binds all nations together is the incompetence of all of their governments. It's not that they make you think they don't know what they're talking about. They don't know what they're talking about, and that's the problem with American politics, because qualified people don't run, usually.
The unions are the mafia, which is the CIA, which is the Catholic Church, which is the government, which is, what's the difference? It's corrupt. It's the same guys pulling these strings, you know, and one day pulls a string and poof, this lamp comes out. You know, the next day he pulls a string and there's a missile coming out.
The way I look at it, take a look at the people who have been presidents in the United States so far. Could I do any worse? If I didn't know shit from Shinola, could I do any worse?
If you would compare the president's Zappa, what would be the main differences you could work out?
I work more hours. And I'm awake.